So I just took out these cakes. My little niece's birthday was on February 3rd, and after everything happened with my dad dying on January the 23rd, I just gotten around to baking her cakes. So this is how they look coming out of the oven. It's going to be a chocolate three-layer cake with vanilla cream icing, and of course I'm going to do a little bit of decorating for her. So once I get these decorated, I will show you the finished product. It's the cream icing that I've made for her cake. And once they cool, we will add this. We will be back with the next video. Okay, so I've got my niece's cake out of the pans, and I just did a little icing in the middle of it so I can get them out of the pans, because if you let them stay in the pan, it'll stick and it'll be hard to get out the pan. So what you see here is on top is the almond flour that I put in the pan along with the cocoa. So that'll all be covered up. That's just almond flour. So once I get done with the complete icing, as you can see, it kind of looks like an Oreo cookie. But once we get done, once the cake completely cools, then I can ice the tops and the side and do my little decorative, and we'll be back to show you more. So this is the finished product of my niece's cake. I think it looks pretty good. This is the finished product. Her name is Kayla. I just did a little something, something, put some little powder on the top to make it a little bit of tangy. And that's how it looks, you guys. Yay. I think it turned out well. I like it. It's nice. She'll be happy. She's 8. So, this concludes the cake for my niece. And on the layers, they were really dark because I put dark cocoa powder in the pans along with almond flour. That helps it keeps it from sticking, and it also makes it better when icing, once you let it sip. And it came out good.